Hey there, Professor Wiseguy here on location for another school visit from my past. After I left the University of Missouri at Columbia, I came to Liberty, Missouri and William Jewell College, where I'm now standing. William Jewell is like a lot of smaller liberal arts colleges around the country. They're one of the few that haven't felt compelled to change their name to university while not really changing much of anything at all. But William Jewell is where I earned my bachelor's degree, a BA in English. I know that surprises you. And it was generally a great place for me to be. So let's talk about the good and the bad things about a place like William Jewell. But what's the good stuff? Well, in the years that I was at William Jewell, I had a set of professors who put teaching first, for the most part at least. You know, at big universities, faculty are often expected to be researchers and publishers first. If they happen to be able to teach, then, well, that's a bonus. At smaller schools like William Jewell, they tend to put teaching first. If you don't really want to be a teacher, then you probably won't try to get a job here. And you probably won't be very happy staying here if you can't teach. Now, to be fair, the professors here were not universally wonderful, but it would be unusual to find anywhere that every faculty member is dynamite. Unlike a lot of schools, Jewell had, and I believe still has, most of the classes taught by full-time tenure-track professors. When I was thinking about trying to get a job here, they had only one part-time or adjunct teacher in the English department. She covered two classes most semesters. To put that in context, my current employer had about twice as many adjunct faculty as full-timers, and those adjuncts were teaching well over half the classes. Now, I'm not trying to put down adjunct professors, but when you only need one, you can be really selective. When you have 50 or 60, you're likely to have a few of them who aren't quite the top of the heap. Besides having generally stronger teaching, smaller schools are, well, smaller. You're more likely to have people who watch out for you a little bit when it comes to a smaller school. When I was at Mizzou that one semester, I didn't have anybody watching out for me. But at William Jewell, I had an advisor who, get this, he actually advised. One time, when I had missed a number of history classes, he called me in and asked what was going on. Now, that's the matter for another video, but the bottom line is that somebody seemed to care. Along the same lines, the people in the financial aid office actually knew me, and they seemed to really care about me. I wasn't just one of a zillion students. Maybe they somehow sensed that someday I'd be Professor Wiseguy. Yeah. What else is good about the smaller school? Well, classes tend to be smaller. Faculty tend to know their students far better. By and large, the campuses are safer. There's a lot to like about a place like William Jewell. But everything can't be glitter and rainbows, can it?
So what is the dark, seamy side of a school like William Jewell?
Okay, to be honest, to the best of my knowledge, there is no dark and seamy side. But there are aspects that aren't ideal. So let's take an easy one. When I was at William Jewell, there were, if I'm correct, two professors in the Spanish department. There were two in political science, two in economics, and three, I think, in history. So who cares? Let's say you want to be an economics major at a school sporting a whole two economics professors. You take a class from Professor A, but you just don't hit it off with that person. Maybe it's none of your fault, it's none of the professor's fault. The two of you just don't click. Now, what do you do? Well, if you're at a school that has 10 economics professors, it's not that big a deal, right? You've got nine others to choose from. But if you're at a school with a department of two, well, then you either take all your remaining classes from that professor or you'd start looking for a new major. This sort of thing hit me early on in an even larger department, education. For a brief season, I entertained the foolish notion that I would teach high school English. To do that, I had to get an education degree, and To earn that, I had to take this dreadful class called Educational Psychology. Now, in the department at Jewell, one person taught that class. You took it from him, or you didn't take it. As it turned out, I didn't have a beef with the professor, I had a beef with the subject matter. And I ran away screaming from the education department at a fairly quick time span. But if I had failed to click with that one professor, I would have had a tough decision to make. A limited pool of faculty can lead to other problems at smaller schools. In a small department, you would have a smaller range of classes and a smaller number of interests on the professor's parts. Similarly, that limited pool means that you have a fairly limited number of specialties among those professors. Undergraduate education is supposed to be general in nature, but that doesn't mean that you don't dabble in some specialized things. Let's say you're an English major and you're fascinated with Ernest Hemingway. At a huge university, there's probably somebody who will be teaching about Hemingway. But at a small school, you just have to get lucky. Probably the biggest drawback of the small liberal arts college is cost. Sticker price at William Jewell is considerably more than at the University of Missouri, my local state school. It was that way when I attended both schools, and it still is today. That difference grows even larger when you look at the lower tier state school. On the other hand, don't always judge the price by the sticker. You may well be able to get more financial aid through that pricey place, which may bring the cost much closer together. As an example, my daughter, a decent cello player, received a very nice scholarship at a similar school to this. Had she taken those talents to a larger school, where a bunch of pretty decent cello players show up, then they wouldn't have been nearly as generous. Also, when the financial aid office has a few hundred freshmen to deal with, rather than a few thousand, they can probably spend a little more specialized, individualized time on you. The bottom line is that if you really want to go to someplace smaller and pricier, then at least talk to them before you write it off as unrealistically expensive. After 3.5 years enrolled at William Jewell, I walked around the campus with a few hundred of my closest friends. We trailed behind a bagpiper because, well, why not? And then we made our way down the hill to the gym to receive diplomas and then revel in our newfound graduatedness. I have no real regrets for choosing to stay at a small school like William Jewell. Could some things have been better? Yeah. Could I have done a better job of using my time here? Yeah. But let's not talk about me. In the comments down below, you can share what you think of this. Am I wrong about small schools? Have I missed the boat? Let me know. Otherwise, get out of here.